Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is NgNews with the latest updates from the Angular community in 100 seconds every week. Ng Poland hosted a Q&A session with 7 members of the Angular team, and these are the main takeaways. First, why did the Angular team decide to make RxJS optional?
We primarily want to remove it from the critical learning journey. If you are just getting started with Angular, it could be overwhelming to learn hundreds of RxJS operators from the beginning. Also, it doesn't maybe make sense to be used in all the places that it's currently being used.
Would you say that the Angular framework is getting less opinionated?
I think what we are doing is being very thoughtful about where Angular having an opinion about something brings real value to the community, and where us having an opinion about something just maybe adds noise.
When will NgModules be deprecated? That depends on us. If a lot of issues on GitHub pop up where developers ask why we still have NgModules, then the Angular team will think about retiring them. And do we have a final recommendation in regards to dependency injection via the constructor or the inject function? No, we don't. It depends on the standardization process of the parameter decorators which we use in the constructor. We'll just have to wait. Netanel Basal quite often publishes articles about upcoming features in Angular. His latest article is about the signal inputs. And Evgenyi Tuboltsev published an article where he explains on how to migrate signals into an existing large application without changing too much of the code base. He's applying a technique where a property is replaced by a getter method which internally calls a signal. That's it. Wishing you a nice weekend and see you in the next episode. Goodbye.